Hello, everybody. I've already fucked up the intro. Hello, everybody. This is Vitten, aka BitBee, and welcome out to another BitBee stream. Thanks for coming out. Happy Wednesday. Anywho, I don't have a whole lot to talk about here, and screwing up the intro kind of messed me up. Anywho, so today we're going to be playing a little more Bomberman Hero, because, like I mentioned in the last stream, like, hey, wouldn't it be cool if I just did some more Bomberman Hero, and apparently there was kind of a resounding yes to everybody, so hell yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Oh, before I forget, just another reminder, if anybody has any recommendations for music that you'd like to hear in the pre-rolls before this thing starts, let me know, because, I mean, like, I'm not exactly a music buff when it comes to coming up with some good stuff, but in general, I try to find some, like, video game soundtrack music, so if you've got some video game tracks that you're a gigantic fan of, I don't know, let me know, like, either, like, in the comments of the YouTube video, or let me know in the chat. I would totally be interested in hearing about what you guys really like to listen to, and I'm a huge fan of video game music in general. So anyway, let's go ahead and get this thing a start. Hold on a second. Oh, and also, I'm going to make absolutely certain that the audio is down to its minutest points. If you watched the last Bomberman Hero stream, you know. For some reason, Bomberman Hero, it outputs, like, I don't, maybe it's just the N64 or just something, but Bomberman Hero specifically, it has absolutely no volume, no low volume points in it at all. It just streams at extreme highs at all times. Here, I'm gonna move the microphone around. I apologize if it bumps at all. There we go. Okay. Game start. Click. Alright. Oh, and I'm also gonna... Here. I'm gonna check the output just to make sure it's not blaringly loud for you guys. It might be. Okay. Testing, testing. No, that works. It's at the exact same settings as last time, but I just want to make sure. That's the humane thing. Alright. So, last we left off, we left off on the second planet after completely, pretty much obliterating the first one in the first stream that we did. Okay. Heading off to Primus. I always thought the Primus looked like a really cool planet. So, hold on a second. Yeah, the weird... Whatever the hell those are. Are those supposed to be, like, the castles? Like, is that what Area 2 is supposed to be? Just that square over there? Like, that's... If we're looking at a planet that is just a regular-sized old planet, then... I mean, I assume it's not, because... An entire giant planet that's just Bomberman's face. It'd be nice if the planet was actually facing us, goddammit. Anywho. I seem to remember that the game gets fairly more difficult the later you get on in planets. However, I seem to remember that I got stuck on the first planet a lot more when I was younger. Then again, I was younger. Much more naive. Oh, more plot. Oh, yeah. Basically, the plot's kind of like just Star Wars. The princess is very close. Whatever, R2. Just hand me the CD. She's inside Primus Castle. Neato. Primus Castle is just ahead, but the guard is tough. I could take him. I have, like, 5 billion tons of C4 in my underwear, whatever. Find the underground tunnel that's connected to the lake. Gotcha. Bomberman, he's a very can-do kind of guy. Alright, I seem to remember these guys are a dick. Oh. Oh, Jesus. Stop it. Drop bomb. Ah. Yeah, I can only drop one bomb at a time. Shit. There you go. Heh. Yeah. I never really understood how to defeat those guys until, like, just now. Suppose I'm a lot smarter of a gamer, as I was back when I was a kid. Back when I was a kid, I was just terrified of them. Just like, don't aggro them, don't aggro them. That's a lot easier. Jesus. The hell's wrong with me? Oh, fuck. There you go. Okay. I guess one of the nice things about this game is that enemies don't just respawn. Oh, good lord. I forgot you did that. Come on. Rebud, you bastard. There you go. Okay, chase me. Oh, wait. Fucking hell. Come on. There we go. Oh, crap. There we go. Yeah, I feel like I'm going to be able to get this game a little bit easier nowadays. I do remember you saw the other save that I did. You know, Planet 5. I beat the game at one point. Bang. Aw, man. I was kind of shooting. I was hoping for a double kill there. Goddamn. Ooh. Bomb them. Bomb them. Leave. Leave no heretic alive. Yes. Exactly. Fuck this world. C4. Hell, why don't we just nuke the planet? That makes sense. There we go. Okay, I seem to remember that jumping into water hurts you for no adequate reason. Aside from the fact that, oh, this game needs something that hurts Bomberman. Aside from just enemies. What? Okay. I was kind of expecting a bomb to just break the box, but okay. There we go. Okay, anything hidden back here? No. Nope, 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 nope. Okay, this is a warp to, I think, just another plate. Oh, actually, I think I remember something that happens that's kind of cool here. Now that I look at these trees, I actually remember something cool. Oh shit, I didn't read that. Whatever, it probably just has something to do with... Hey, bomb shit. Okay. Got it. Come on. Stop being a wuss. There you go. Okay, bomb number one. There we go. That's done and done. Okay, now I'm trying to remember. I need to get over there. Oh, wait a minute. Ooh. Ooh. Firepower. And now I gotta attack this guy. I think I can use my rolling attack in order to beat this guy. Yeah, oh! Oh! That's right! Yeah, it's a snow machine. Releases snow. And now I don't have to worry about the ice anymore, because, you know, I kind of fucked this planet. Oh! Hey, buddy. There we go. Speaking of which, I don't know, maybe... I was trying to think of how the green atmosphere makes sense for this planet. Because for the most part, all the environment around here kind of just looks Earth-esque. You gonna attack me or... There. Whatever. Alright. Oh, yeah. I just remembered that a lot of the treasure... If you want, like, a high score, and if you want a good rating on these things, then you have to collect all the treasures. Good lord. I think... By the end of my last stream, like, I absolutely just stopped caring, and I ended up just getting through the map without having to worry about the treasures. I feel like nearing the end of this stream, I'm probably going to get to that point where I'm like, you know what? No, no, never mind, I don't care. Ratings be damned, I just want to beat the damn game. There we go. Okay, this is going to be a lot of busy work. Oh, here, one cool thing I wanted to talk about. I was doing a little bit of just derping around on Twitter, and I learned about this new program. Let me look over at my tabs real quick. I got my internet browser up. Yeah, it's this chat program called Discord. And I only recently heard about it, like, just earlier today. And it's this really freaking cool software. For the longest time, I've been trying to find something to replace Skype. Like, Skype's always been kind of a necessary evil. Like, I haven't known too many people that actually actively really like Skype, or who think that it's designed very well. I mean, it used to be. Skype used to be a very good program, and then Microsoft bought it. They kind of stopped giving a shit. It kind of got to a point where it's like, hey, we've got the best thing ever. We have the best servers ever. Why even worry about coding it? Whatever. Let's see. Oh, otherwise I don't go to face the true boss. Fuck. Okay, so I've never actually truly defeated this game. Damn it. I don't know if I want to do that. You know what? Especially for the sake of not wasting time on here. If I ever get to a point where I really do want to face the true boss, I'll do a whole bunch of that, you know, all of that kind of stuff on my off time. Like, I don't care too much about doing any of that. I'm just playing a game for the sake of playing a game.
I did it!
Damn it. Missed 100. There was probably like one jewel or something just sitting around doing nothing. Ugh. Oh god, I remember this place. Okay, so, remember when I said, like, you know, what's up with these planets? This looks just like Earth. Never mind. Nope, we've officially hit alien territory. There we go. Oh yeah, and then when these guys combine, they make a shitty, really powerful enemy. God damn it. Die. There we go. Anywho. But no, that's what this new program that I recently found. What they're aiming to do is they finally want to make pretty much the replacement for Skype. And TeamSpeak, I guess, but I don't know. TeamSpeak, that's been used by... TeamSpeak is just a slightly crappier version of Skype. I'm not going to say crappier. It has its uses, but it doesn't have as many utilities. Like, it kind of fails on the video streaming kind of thing. Like, if you wanted to do some webcasting, basically the best thing for PC users for the longest time has been Skype. You really couldn't do anything else aside from Skype for webcam stuff. I mean, you could, but kind of sucked. Ah! Where are you? But I will say one thing, like, one of the worst things about Skype, at least for, stuff like what I do, it's absolutely terrible for an audiophile. I mean, I'm not, like, a super audiophile, but one of the things that absolutely bothers me about Skype is that it has some built-in shitty software that auto-levels all of your equipment. So, you could be talking to one of your friends. I'm sure a lot of people have dealt with this before, where you're talking to your friend. Oh, isn't there a way to warp in these things or something? Oh, there is! Sweet. Okay. Now, I'm sure you've been talking to a friend or just a colleague or just something on Skype, and then all of a sudden, suddenly there's, like, I don't know, a dishwasher or a laundry machine that's in the background that's just making a very subtle hum. And then all of a sudden, like, he's just like, okay, I'm gonna be away from my keyboard for a little bit. Can you just hold on a second? It's like, oh yeah, sure. They leave to, like, go to the bathroom. And then in the time that they're gone, in the time they're going to the bathroom, suddenly the audio coming from their side of the phone call gets ridiculous. Let's see. I'm not doing very good on hearts, Jesus. But I want to see if this thing warps me too. Yeah? Yep. I was wondering how you get that gem. I'm like, that's a way too difficult jump to make somebody do. Oh yeah, that's how you figure it out. I just figured it out by memory. Okay. But yeah, I've had a lot of friends who, like, were just on a Skype call and were like, oh god, kick him from the call. Fuck. He's super loud. Fuck it. Get him out of the call. And that's why I've been wanting to find a better don't know, just something better than Skype, especially since they've recently started to add a lot of updates to try and streamline it into, like, you know, the 21st century. It's like, hey, guess what? It'll automatically download files that are sent to you. That's not a good thing, Skype. I kind of want to get prompts whenever some random, I don't know, just some random person decides to send me a file. You know, like, God forbid I actually make a decision on whether or not I want to download spyware. Yeah, fuck that. Asshat. Can I hit him from here? There we go. And that was kind of the big thing. It's like, you know, for images, I guess that's okay. Like, I'm not too terrified of accidentally getting some kind of a virus off an image. Oh, Jesus, these guys. See, I forget, do these guys give you points? They do, so you have to actively try and kill these guys too. Jesus. I guess the better that I can do right now, the less work I gotta do on my off time trying to, you know, fix my laziness. There we go. Oh my god, I have been trying to look for a program that replaces Skype for the longest time just because I have this serious vendetta about it. And I've been following a whole bunch of different projects, like there's Razer Comms. They've been doing a whole lot of stuff involved with Razer Comms, and one of the nice things about Razer Comms is that they seem to be... They're focusing a lot on, like, the gaming aspect of Razer Comms. And that's nice, because sometimes I like to use, sometimes I like to use these kinds of programs for chatting with my friends and playing video games. So that makes sense, that's cool. But the issue is that it seems like Razer Comms seems to be bare bones Skype, and that's it. They kind of just do everything that Skype does and calls it a day. Actually, no, not everything Skype does. They don't do the video stuff. And that's kind of like the big draw to Skype. Like Google Hangouts, it does an okay job, I guess. By okay, I mean it exists. But the, like, the call quality when it comes to Skype video is absolutely... Oh, wait, not Skype video. Google Hangouts video is terrible. Oh, I got an extra 50. Neat. Oh god, is this a swimming one? I'm gonna warn you guys in right now. I am not gonna get everything in this. Cause yeah, fuck that. I'm gonna have to look through like a walkthrough or something just to see what the perfect route would be for defeating everything. Okay, that's the bomb button, right? Ah! Careful, I only have one heart. Of course, like I said in the last stream, it doesn't make too much sense because you have infinite lives. So you can just die and then come back and you'll be okay. I mean, the worst that's gonna happen is that you're gonna lose progress. Oh god. Sweet, sweet progress. I'm gonna have to do a challenge again? Oh. Whatever, man. Oh, hey, an extra life. I feel like I'm gonna need that extra life sooner as opposed to later. Oh, Jesus. Oh, oops. I forgot. The bomb explosion stack. Alright. Back to the grind. I keep impulsively pressing the B button to try and bomb things. Then I'm like, oh yeah, shit, torpedoes, that's right. God damn it. This is why I hate the water levels. It throws all of the controls on its ear. Anywho. But no, for this Discord program, it actually seems to be... It seems to be being made and developed by a company that isn't absolutely full of shit. Like, I actually genuinely went and check them out and check out what they're doing. And I've seen some of their videos just for their announcements, and they actually seem like genuinely funny people. You know, with an actual sense of humor and an actual gaming background. And that's kind of the major... asshole. Okay, so I'm just gonna have to keep swimming forward. Come on. There we go. Dirtbag. Oh, I'm trying to remember. They just did a recent announcement for... Oh god, what was it? I think it was just the advertisement that it works a lot with... It works with, like, game overlays. Oh wait, that's what it was. Like, their game overlay system. Where select amount of games, you'll be able to just have the comm window open on your game at all times. So you can go over and quickly send somebody a message. Oh shit. Oh no. Is this one of those, like, you know, pick a room, any room kind of thing? Yep. Yep, it is. Shit. Oh! I think I picked the right one. Or I picked the completely wrong one and I'm about to be raped by sharks. That is also possible. There we go. Alright. Oh, I'm trying to think. One of the cool things about Discord that I found out is that they are actively about to work on the video call feature. Like, I don't think they've started to work on it, but they have made the announcement that once they get their friends list thing set up, they're going to work on two other things, which is group calls and their video calling functions. Oh, and screen sharing. And once they do that, I'm completely off Skype. I'm throwing the program at everybody that I know, and I'm telling them, like, even grandparents, you should just get it for grandparents, send it to them, and just be like, okay, this is the brand new Skype. Ignore the original one. This is the new. Oh yeah, this map. The one that is completely absent of any musics. To any of the musics. There we go. You'll have to let me know. Anybody in the chat, has there ever been another Bomberman game to come out that was similar to this? Oh, shit. I want the crystals. I want them. Now that I know that there's an actual, like, you know, final boss, now I actually really, really want to collect everything. God damn it. Damn completionist tendencies. How do I get up there? I think I have to pull some real bullshit moves by, like, jumping onto the side here. There we go. And then somehow jumping onto that pipe. I could be wrong. Let's see. Oh, damn. God. Fuck. Alright, let's try it again. Try to collect everything. Oh! Okay. I'm really happy that I have the ability to grab ledges, otherwise this, just the slidey movement would have been bullshit. There we go. No, you will not know true horror until you attempt to do something over Skype. Like, one thing that I've tried to do in the past was play music over Skype. That is a dreadful fucking thing. Oh, you know, another thing that's really obnoxious is, Skype kind of, like, auto-decides who gets priority over the audio coming from the call. So if you do try to play music through Skype, it's going to just... Oh, God, fuck. Alright. I feel like I should just say fuck it to that area up there and call it a day. Damn it. Otherwise, I'm just gonna kill myself constantly. Now, I don't know if anybody's ever dealt with this, where one person's side of the conversation is extremely loud, while everybody else's is, you know, fairly normal levels of audio. And so, everybody else's voices are getting cut out, like, in really weird, patchy bullcrap. Like, it's gotten to the point where... Skype's automation has gotten to a point where it is actually interfering with the call quality. And of course, they'll say, hey, these features are for call quality, man. Like, the reason that we even put these features in is because we care about your call quality. No, you fucking don't. Like, you're trying to come up with sort of a simplified... that's kind of what it is. Skype is the simplified... What would I call it? Basically, a consumerist product. I'm just trying to make sure that I don't fall off. Like, every synapse in my brain is telling me, please, don't fall off. Like, you're gonna talk your mouth off for the next 30 seconds, and in the 30 seconds, you are just gonna immediately pass off the edge. Oh, shit! Okay, I'm alive. Oh, fuck! How many lives do I have? One. Neat. I don't remember if that one life counts as the one that I'm using right now or not. Again, lives don't really matter in this game. Just kind of an inconvenience, and you lose whatever checkpoints you had. Whatever. There we go. So that was one cool thing that I saw earlier. Is it sad that, like, something as simple as that, just like, oh my god, new voice chat. Just completely brightens up my day. And I need stuff like that, because sometimes just there's so much bullshit and bad news going on. Just, it's the tiny things, really. Yo. What other tiny things have happened lately? Oh, I saw this news, I saw this thing in the news that apparently the ex-administrator of 4chan has been picked up by Google Plus. Oh, God. That was a funny news report to read. I genuinely don't think it's gonna make any difference whatsoever in what Google Plus is doing, especially considering he's not exactly an administrator of Google. But wouldn't it be friggin' funny if suddenly Google Plus just became 4chan? Or just something to that effect? Alright, I'm not gonna get a perfect score anyway, so whatever. There. Why is it that on this planet there's enemies that I've already dealt with before? Oh yeah, I was talking about this, I was about to say this in chat. Guys, if there were any games of Bomberman that came out that were made in this sort of style, like, even if it didn't come out in America, like, if there was just some Japanese equivalent of this that came out, I would be interested in playing it. I kind of miss this kind of Bomberman. Like, most Bomberman games focus on multiplayer nowadays. And it'd be kind of cool if I could just go back and play something on the equivalent of this. Alright, so that was Area 1. Let's go to Area 2. Yay, more plot. Oh god, the princess. Okay. Smooth. Go save her, you glorious explosive bastard. Alright. Don't think I can get up there. Whatever. Let's see. Oh, Jesus! Nope. Oh, there's a hole there. Oh, I suppose if I wanted to save myself, I could jump in the hole. Alright. Oh, fuck. It's okay. Okay, now these are death pits. Neat. Okay, there's a heart. Don't feel like getting that. Oh, fuck! Okay, maybe now I feel like getting it. Are these stones, like, directly above where, like, you know, presents and, you know, trophies are? Gemstones. God damn it. Oh, Jesus! Careful, Bomberman. Okay. Oh. If I want a perfect score, I have to get it. Okay. Will you stop throwing boulders? Not playing a goddamn Indiana Jones game. Has there ever been Indiana Jones games? It just occurred to me. That'd be weird. Okay, can I just bomb that? Alright, good. You know, I never realized, but this game very much is just blow the fuck out of it, that's it. Oh. The solution tends to always be just blow it up. Kick its ass. It's not too much thought you have to put into it. Yep. Okay, poison gas. There we go. Jesus Christ! Oh my god, what the hell? I don't remember that at all. I feel like that should have given me nightmares. What the hell? Okay, hey! Sweet. Got enough points. I had to deal with that, like, horrible nightmare door, but alright. Sorry if I peeked the mark there, that was, like, genuinely, it's like, what the fuck? Okay, so doors can be sentient now, that's good. Oh. Hey, bomb rat, I think when I kill him, his bomb tail ends up, like, chasing after me. Yep, 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 run! It's okay. I'm not entirely dead yet. Okay. Hello, chickadee. Alright, where to now? What do I get? What do I need? More death water. Nope. Oh god. Eh. Come on, you. Ah, okay. There. Oh, yeah, and I guess if I wanted to get. Oh. Those things, good. They're so much easier now. My god. That's one of the cool things about coming back to games like this. Like, the games that you played as a child, because... Oh, no. This is going to require me to not fuck up this jump. I fucked up the jump! Fucking hell. Alright, is there any way for me to teleport back up there? Damn it. All right, fine. No, there are one or two games that they're a lot easier once you have better, like, finger dexterity and more common sense when it comes to video games. Oh, Jesus. Did I say I have better dexterity? I meant fuck me. Oh god. I've never tried to get the red and the yellow one together before. I imagine it makes just a hellish orange color that destroys me immediately. It's okay. with this game, the only the solution is always bombs. Just when in doubt, just blow up everything. It's fine. There we go. All right. Forward. Wow, I'm really glad I checked this. All right. Let's see. Oh, God. I don't have a whole lot to talk about. This game's kind of straightforward. Just like when you need to get past a certain area, just blow shit up. I will say, I did think about that the other day. And one thing I definitely want to try and avoid doing is just talking for the sake of talking. Like, I've seen a lot of streamers that they just talk for the sake of filling a quota. Like filling in dead space. You know what? Sometimes dead space is there for a good reason. Like, you have nothing interesting to talk about? Good. Just don't talk about anything. It's fine. You know, let the gameplay take over for a short period of time. You'll be okay. Like, silence is not the end of the world. Do I take door A or B? Yeah, you know, I'm gonna take that one. Damn it! Shit. Not perfect. No, seriously, now that I know about, like, you know, the true boss of this game, I'm genuinely curious, because I've never seen the true boss before. I've only played this game up to, you know, the supposed ending. Apparently I completely skipped Million Road. Okay, warp room. Remember this place? Oh, Jesus. Oh, okay. Okay. Come over here and explode, please. I seem to remember a lot of this stuff intimidating me a lot more when I was a kid. I'm very much unenthused nowadays. Oh, fuck. Yeah, that was a smart decision. Electricity coils. The game's over. That's the best thing for your complexity. Just electrocute yourself. Okay, so noted. There's two of these goddamn things in here. There. It's one. And we are done. God, I'm trying to remember the more weird news that I've recently seen. Blow up. There we go. What was inside this box? Here. Oh! Okay, death was inside that box. Never mind. There. Oh, yeah, that's right. You have to go open. Yeah, you have to activate that by going through warps. Yes. That's why it's called warp room. Oh, good. I remember the barrel with eyes. This game was so quirky. Oh yeah, I just remembered something that I was kind of musing about the other day. I mean, I've heard other people talk about this before, but it kind of just suddenly popped into my mind, like, I think yesterday. It's weird to think that a long time ago, I was kind of the only nerd within my circle of, I don't know, just the circle of students that were at the school. So there was not a whole lot of people that were, you know, playing video games or doing stuff on the computer. And one of the weirdest things about just the internet nowadays is finding people that are actively talking about your childhood. Like, that's freaky as hell. You know, like, for instance, like, I was talking about Chameleon Twist, like, you know, to no end for the longest period of time back there. And I'm talking about it now, goddammit. Hello, Diamond Mike. Good to see you. Come on. My own platform. There we go. Anyway, no, it's just weird to see people playing your childhood games when a long time ago when you were a kid, it's just like, nobody cares about it. Indestructible barrel? Okay, there we go. The hell, man. Okay, I think this is an exit, but I should skip it until I reach, like, the real true exit. If I'm remembering this right. Because I think that platform... Oh, right. I think I'm supposed to jump up here. And then, yeah, because the other moving platform was activated. Yeah. If we're specifically playing for points, then... You gotta think a little bit outside the box. Oh, this is where I started. Okay, whatever. There we go. I'm trying to remember some other games from my childhood that, like, nobody would have even heard of before. Oh, here's a weird thing. Oh. Let's see what's up here first. Hold on. Oh, it's... Wait, never mind. It's just teleporter back here. Yep, all the points. Here's a really weird, obscure thing. I remember my first introduction to a lot of... Okay, I need to get the key crystals, whatever. My first introduction to a lot of, like, DOS games... That barrel had arms. Okay, do I... Yep, I bomb this. Cool. My introduction to a lot of DOS games was on this really weird game compilation. I'm trying to remember. I think it was, like... a Zodiac game compilation that had like 50 DOS games on it. I'm trying to remember some of the games that it had on it. I think like Super Hexagon was one of them. Like, I was really, really tempted to try my best to find that thing again. Because, oh, for God's sakes, like, I think if you look it up on Google, you can find the name, but I don't think you're ever going to find anybody who actually sells it. Now, it was just this this game compilation that allowed you to play a whole bunch of old DOS games on newer... it's odd to say newer. Windows 98 computers. So let me think. Yeah, Super Hexagon was one of them, if anybody remembers that. I don't know, it's basically sort of a board... Oh, shit. Ape Escape? Yeah, I remember that. I never played Ape Escape, but I did see a whole lot of people that talked about it. But it's weird just to see other people talking about these video games that, as a child, you were like, oh, okay, so nobody has any idea. Apparently, I live in my own little world here. Oh, I don't think I ever tried to go up here. Hold on. Oh, wait, did I? My brain suddenly, like, recollected itself. I'm like, oh yeah, you did do that, you idiot. Wait. Hello. I'll drop a bomb here. I seem to remember, I think this board is one of the boards that allows you to play with, like, the remote control bombs. if my memory serves me right. Oh god. That was close. Let me see. I think I talked about this game in another stream that I did, Tetrisphere. Did anybody ever play that N64 game? That game was I want to say substandard, but I think it was lower than that. I think it was like there's standard, there is half standard, which I consider substandard. And then there was that one, which was like a fifth lower than substandard. Basically, the idea was it was sort of Tetris pieces, except in sort of a 3D environment. And good God, it was a game. That was it. That's pretty much all I can describe it for. It's like, it's a game. Oh God, here. Yeah. Oh, hey, neat. I remember the name Time Splitters, but I've... Good lord, what... Refresh my memory, what console? Because I remember hearing the name Time Splitters, but I can't place it. Oh, careful. Hey, bastard. Oh yeah, here's the time bombs. Oh shit. See. Yeah, I can see the piece directly behind this thing. There we go. Oh, PS2. Yeah. I love how people in the chat are like, yeah, Time Splitters, fuck yeah! See, that's why I never heard of it, because I wasn't a PS2 kid. Ah, shit! Hey, guess what? We have to do all that again. Jesus. Okay. Actually, weirdly enough, we did own a PS2. Yeah, you told me about Time Splitters before. So maybe that's where I heard about it. Maybe that's why it was so it was ringing so loud in my memories. Like, Time Splitters, Time Splitters. I was told about this. Should I know this better? Please, brain work. God damn it, brain. Now, oddly enough, we actually did own a PlayStation 2 at one point. I feel really guilty about this, but here's what ended up happening. My brother loaned it out to somebody who wanted to play a game on it, and then it just disappeared and never returned to the house. Now, I feel very bad about that, because I really should have pressed the issue and just been like, where the fuck is the PS2? You know, like, that's a $200 piece of equipment and it's just gone? What the hell? Why is it gone? But I didn't, I just kind of stopped caring. Probably because there was a GameCube nearby, so... I feel terrible about that nowadays. Then again, we didn't really have any killer apps on that. Rystar, Chameleon Twist 2, Bomberman, Vectorman, good lord. Yeah. I'm son of a... I'm so bad. It's okay, we'll get through this. We can dang old do it. There we go. I'm trying to remember... Oh, some other games that fell into obscurity for me. I'm sure there's a ton of them. Oh my god, have you guys ever played that that one mobile Banjo-Kazooie game? The one on the Game Boy Advance? Banjo-Kazooie Gruntilda's Revenge. Oh boy. That was shit. Now, I genuinely want to see this. I want to know if, like, anybody out there actually played that thing. Now, I was originally planning on making a video about it. Like, an actual produced video. But then I realized there's, God, nothing to talk about with that game. Like, nothing. Or at least nothing interesting. Okay. Oh, hey, an extra life. So that means if we die, we can just perpetually keep going on this level. Nice. Bad game. Please, No, please, bad game, man, lol. I'm not entirely sure what you're freaking out about, either me dying or Banjo, I'm not sure. See, I can actually see all of the, all of those crystal pieces over there. Alright. I gotta be careful where I'm jumping. Otherwise, we're just gonna be, in the exact same... Oh, fuck. Did you guys see that? Like, the game glitched out for a second there. I don't know if that was my, my processor or something. Yeah, I think it's the Banjo game. I would not be surprised. Basically, they tried to make a, sort of a 3D platformer Zelda, except in 2D on the Game Boy Advance. And good lord, that didn't work. that did not work. There we go. See. Although, surprisingly, I think I beat that game, just because I had absolutely nothing else to play on Game Boy Advance at the time. I tend to do that, I don't know why. I'll be playing a bad game, and then for absolutely no reason, I'll continue to play it. I'll just be like, well, I got nothing else to do. Oh, fuck! Ah, God. Oh, yeah, GBA had a lot of crap. Well, when it wasn't a port, or something that actually had some thought to it. Like, everything was on the GBA at one point. Everything. Even obscure, crappy SNES games that desperately... Yeah, wow. Kind of sets the bar for what kind of... I'm not exactly MLG pro gamer here. There we go. It's okay, we got an extra life. There we are. Wow. Just... Wow. Wow. Yes. Okay. Hey, buddy, I need into your little prison. Why are you locked up anyway? Is this, like, is this the prison for all of the bad guys that were not quite bad enough? Or they were bad, but not in the way that the actual people running this establishment wanted. Okay. Don't you do that. Oh, you goddamn barrel. Yeah. Everything is solved by throwing a bomb at it, yes. I mentioned that before. It's just like, well, fuck this switch. Bang. Everything holds up very well, despite that. You'd think this entire place would just be covered in craters by now. Okay, now I mentioned it before. I think I'm gonna wait until the platform comes up. Yeah, there we go. Oh, you hate how the Wii still Bayonetta. You know, I don't care too much. Like, I mean, first off, I'm not a gigantic fan of Bayonetta. Oh yeah, I forgot. Time bombs. Yeah, I suppose I shouldn't use the shadow. Yeah, yeah. I've been trying, man. I'm not completely inept at this game, but God help me, I'm pretty inept. Where was the other one? I feel like... Two more that I'm completely spacing on. Problem is, I've revisited these areas so many times, I'm not entirely sure which places I've actually been to, and which places I haven't. Yeah. Yeah, this is new territory. Oh boy. I'ma time this. There. And... That's three. All we need is one more and we can get the fuck out of here. I don't have the jacket, so I'm gonna have to be careful about this. Damn it! Okay, here. Closer. Oh. A jewel. I'm really nervous. Very, very nervous. Okay, I think the last one is located up here. Yeah, here we go. Okay, now just don't die. Although if I do fuck up somehow, be prepared to just cover your ears. Oh, you're going to hear an infamous and, like, legendary scream. Ah! I don't even care if I got it perfect on that, fuck it. Although that does mean that if I want to get, like, the final boss, apparently, that means that I have to actually go back and do that one again. Anyway, we're fighting Nitros again. I seem to remember that each one of these Nitros missions, he has, like, one new thing for each one of them. What? Oh, for a second there, I thought I was cap- I thought that was my jail cell. What the fuck? I was like, oh, no, we're outside the bars looking in. Okay, never mind. How'd we go from running around their complex to just suddenly- oh, okay.
Bomberman, you're a persistent little creature. I'm not letting this girl go.
Yeah? Fight me! Fight me, IRL! We'll fight again in ADOC. Okay. Whatever. I'm all for it. Although they're gonna take this opportunity to whisk the princess out of here. Okay, so the new thing is those circles. No idea what they do. I'm sure I'll figure that out. Okay. I probably can't touch the red bits. There we go. Kick his ass. Hey! Don't you kick my fucking bombs. Does he have a scouter? Yes. I don't know why he has a scouter. It's not like he's gonna be able to read my power level anyway. It's off the charts. Actually, now that I think about it, I probably don't have the power level. These bombs, on the other hand. Yeah, they are definitely over 9,000. Oh, Jesus! Pay attention, dammit. Okay, he hasn't stopped on one of the circly things yet. I'm scared of what'll happen when he does. Okay, wasn't the last Nitro battle, like, didn't I... Have I ever tried other Bomberman 64 games? I have not, and, depending how I feel about, you know, moving is a virtue here. Freaking Nitros. Oh, here we go. Oh, it's just some disc? Okay. Oh, God. That disc doesn't, like, just perpetually just float around here, does it? Doesn't matter, I won. No, I haven't tried other Bomberman 64 games. I'm interested in seeing them. Actually, I think I remember I rented Bomberman 64 at one point.
I did it!
Oh, God. So if I wanted a perfect score on that, I actually have to beat him in a reasonable time. Oh, are you okay? What happened to the princess? She's not gone, is she? Oh, the princess is in the clock tower. I have to at least play the first one. Yeah. I probably should. Why? Oh. Why put her up there? Isn't she important somehow? You had her locked up at one point. Okay. Never mind. I seem to remember that bird enemy was an absolute torture to try and complete. Okay, Flying Bomberman. Actually, no. It's not the jetpack, it's like the, yeah, bomber copter. I'll just skip through this. To open the killer gate, I have to destroy the 10 submarines, okay. Good to know. So, I assume I just drop bombs on them, right? How do I do that? Oh, okay, trigger. Fuck your couch! Just carpet bottom. She's so dead in 15 minutes. Exactly! It's like, what are you doing, man? You are the worst hostage negotiators of all time. Or like just the worst hostage carriers of all time. Oh, I have to wait for him to go up. To come up, I should say. Oh, Jesus. This might be a little harder than I thought it was gonna be. Especially if I can't find any hearts. Okay. Let's try this again. I wonder if I can hit him from up here. Not if I drop them sequentially like that. I think I need to drop down lower. There. I think they're blowing up in air. They're not even hitting them. Shit. Elemental bombs and light, dark, wind. I'm dead. Sorry, I got... I got flustered by, you know, light, dark, wind, lava bombs. My god, I need to play this game. That sounds so cool. Yeah, again. If I manage to complete this game, yeah. I definitely have it on my list of N64 games, for sure. I don't have a whole lot of them, but I'm pretty sure if I actually look them up, and, you know, put some effort into looking them up, I could find some of the stuff that I rented in the past. And let me tell you, the N64, dark, dark days for Nintendo. Not super dark, but not the best. I don't know, what do you guys think the heyday for Nintendo was? I really feel like it was, like, the Super Nintendo. After that, it was just kind of... I mean, for the N64, they were coming up with the new things, and they were coming up with, like, a really cool... You know, a 3D games concept. I mean, I don't think it was new, but it was definitely new for home consoles, for sure. And then the GameCube, that was probably one of the last really good consoles they had, just because they weren't trying too hard to be gimmicky. I mean, I know their motto, create something unique, I get that. The N64 is better than the Wii, yeah. Better than the Wii U, I would agree. Because, like, at this point, they're really desperately trying to work hard at being interesting. And to an extent, I can understand that, but sometimes you just gotta fit a mold. Especially when developers have no fucking idea what to do with you. Like, that's their biggest problem, is that, jeez, they don't make anything that actually adheres to stuff. And that's why, with all the news recently, or like all the leaks coming out about the Nintendo NX, I'm really, really hoping... I'm hoping it kind of brings them into the current gen a little bit more. Because, god, the Wii U did not do it. Basically, the Wii U brought them into the current gen for about... 4 months, I'll say. And then suddenly it's like, the Xbox One! And the, you know, the PlayStation 4. And that just kind of, you know, fucked up the entire game. There's like, well, shit, now we're not interesting anymore. Good. Alright. Although I will say, I did get extremely sad when I heard about the rumors about the controller. Mario Kart 8 is overrated. Probably, yeah. But overrated is not the same as suck, and I think Mario Kart 8 is actually pretty friggin' awesome. There we go. Okay. Need to grab you. Wonder how I'm doing point-wise. Okay. The NX won't even have third-party support. Shaking my head. Oh. I haven't heard about that rumor. And I genuinely don't think they're going to do something like that. I actually heard that they have really good compatibility with Unreal Engine, actually. Like, the brand new version of Unreal Engine. That was one of the rumors. I suppose it's way too early to tell, that's for sure. But I will say, one of the rumors that I think is basically true is the that patented controller design that they put down. Have you seen that? Basically, imagine the Wii U's like controller, except condensed down to an actual form factor that makes sense for a controller. And that's essentially what the new Nintendo NX controller is supposedly supposed to be. There we go. Hey, fuck off. Okay, I suppose I can take some time to grab the crystals. But no, the second that I saw that they released that patent and that it could tangentially have something to do with the Nintendo NX, I just got very sad. So I'm like, God damn it! You had one shot and you failed, Nintendo. Please, make something. I mean, I say this now, but who wants to bet that sometime very soon in the near future they're going to come out with, you know, this new Zelda game or something to that effect, and we're all just going to buy the newest console? Mm-hmm. I mean, there's also rumors coming from... Yeah. I'm not even close to the 4,000, okay. Okay, Spiral Tower. Don't recall. There we go. That's pretty easy. Okay, more fire! I mean, I really do desperately want to give Nintendo a thumbs up, but they're not helping me do it. That's for sure. Hey, stop moving. There we go. You never were a Zelda fan? I could see that. I will say, like, one of the really awkward things is that I never really grew up with Zelda back in, like, the Super Nintendo age. Or, you know, like, just the Zelda age or the Super Nintendo age. So I never played any of the 2D side-scroller kind of things. Or, you know, just, like, the open... What would you call it? God damn it. I'm sorry, my brain is desperately trying not to get hit by spikes. Yeah, okay, okay. There. I will say, I actually really like the 3D Zeldas. Like, something fierce. Maybe it's because I'm lazy and I don't want to put too much thought into what direction I'm supposed to be going. And the 3D Zeldas do a very good job of just holding your hand the entire goddamn way. I know I shouldn't look at it like that, but... F-Zero would be kind of cool. I mean, heck, wouldn't it be cool if they actually got, put that gamepad to some, like, good use and actually, I don't know, came up with some good... some sub-controls for, some kind of F-Zero game? That'd be neat. Okay. Well, there's one exit. Oh, shit! Well then. You know what? I saw that there was this thing open. Let me follow it, see what's down here. One crystal. I think we can all agree. Everybody has at least something that they really like from Nintendo. Now, if they kind of got their head... If they could get their heads out of their asses long enough to realize that they could be making a lot more money than they are, that would be nice. You know, one thing I really desperately want to see happen from Nintendo, I want to see a more traditional 3D Mario again. Oh shit! You got me, you bastard! Alright. Back to the grind. Oh, right. I can't blow these things up until they're, above ground. Next-gen console Bomberman? Now, I don't quote me on this, but isn't there, like, at least some kind of Bomberman's out there on next-gen consoles? I mean, not super incredible ones. Like, that's, you know, not games like this, that's for certain. But, I mean, they had to have made some kind of a multiplayer Bomberman game at some point and released it on recent consoles, right? Even if it's a multiplayer game. Oh, I didn't really need that. Okay. We don't really need to follow that path down there. Unless we really want to get the perfect score. God damn it. Okay. What was I saying? Alright. I really want to see a more traditional 3D Mario game. I'm talking something along the lines of, like, Super Mario 64 or Super Mario Sunshine. Now, a lot of people, like, God, a lot of people gave Super Mario Sunshine shit when it originally came out. And I put the blame entirely on their goddamn marketing campaign. Do you remember that marketing campaign? In 3D. Oh, wait. The original Bomberman on PS4 or Xbox One in 3D. Something like that. No, but you guys remember that... what was it? I know, it was their weird... You know, cleaning PSA commercial for Super Mario Sunshine. I have absolutely, I'm fairly certain that their advertising and, like, marketing people from that era of commercials is now gone. As a matter of fact, I think they dropped them very soon after Super Mario Sunshine was over. I have a feeling Nintendo probably saw their commercials, like their most recent ones, and went, oh, really? Well, fuck that noise. You guys are out. Can we get somebody that actually appeals to the fucking youth? Yeah, you remember with that jingle? You know, Mario could use a helping hand, or something like that. Let's all lend a helping hand. Mario can't do it alone. I'm like... And then and that actually turned me off from playing the game for a while. Until I went off to... I don't know, the mall or something. I went to Target. And I went and actually played a demo of it. And I actually really, really, really liked the game. Like, I liked the mechanic of the water, like the water gun. And it's kind of liberating to be able to just spray water, you know, like haphazardly, not giving a shit about anything that gets soaked. Like, that was fun. I really liked that game. And after buying it, I was, like, I reaffirmed, just like, yep, that's really awesome. I genuinely think Super Mario Sunshine would have done better had they just had a better marketing team behind it. You know, it'd just be like... I don't know. What would have made the marketing better on that? Like, better taglines and stuff. Right, guys, come up with something in the chat. Like, what would have sold you on Super Mario Sunshine? There. Okay. I'll try not to injure myself on the lifts. Yeah. For some reason, I thought that lift was just gonna squash me or something, and then I forgot. Oh, right. This game doesn't have squash physics. That I know of. But I heard one review, or some interview with one of the heads for Super Mario Sunshine. And he said he would totally be willing to do a Super Mario Sunshine 2. Oh, fuck me! Ugh. Tricky bitches. Oh, get... that's the second time I ran into those. You know, I should probably just exit. Like, there's that one exit that's really easy to get to. I should probably just walk through it. As a matter of fact, that's probably how I got past this stage originally. Oh, God damn it. Die. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna need that heart. Yoink. Oh man, I just thought, kill thyself, yes, for my amusement. Is that all I am? I just your fat material, just like, yes, yes, he's failing miserably at this video game, yes. Let me tell you, you could find better fat material. Hey, thanks for coming in, I appreciate it. Oh, Jesus. Okay. You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna try. I'm gonna try it one more time, just to see if maybe I can get to the top. And if not, yeah, I'm just gonna go through that. Hate. Thank you very much. I appreciate your interest. Of my terrible, terrible game playing skills. There. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna say fuck this. We're just gonna go and go through that one door. Not get hit by these spikes this time. Because yeah, we've tried too many times on this little tower. Anyway, I was just about to muse about this. Actually, did I muse about this before? About how a lot of times there are games that come out in Japan that they don't port over to the US, or like they heavily modify for the US because, oh yeah, it's way too difficult. The US is not gonna get it. Whatever, man. Okay. So this is Snake Route, apparently. And that looks like death. You don't do anything special, do you? No, I just bomb you twice. And you go down like a rock. The hell are you? Oh no, it's another one of these again. Collecting the goddamn spires, alright. We're in for a fun time. Okay, anything hidden up here? I imagine yes. Oh, no. Okay. I was expecting I was gonna find something up there. Bam! I have very super powerful bombs. I'm liking this. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I'm alive. Ah! Don't you do it. What is that sassy stance? Just like, well, what is that stance? Just some matter of fact. Just like, oh, look at you, goody goody two shoes. How do I activate that? Okay. There we go. I feel like I probably missed something. I'm not gonna risk that. You know, I'll come back to it. If I switch something. Oh, Jesus! Okay, well, here's the switch. Okay. Wait for it to come down. Fuck. Blow it the fuck up. Oh god, for some reason, my brain just went to the, god. I don't like referencing, too many, like, online shows, just cause, I don't know, I've always thought it's kind of tacky to reference online shows on an online show. Just throw grenades at me. Well, there we go, so, there's another online show reference. Yeah. No, okay. Cool. No, I was just about to, reference... Oh, the one thing from DBZ Abridged. Just like, oh, Earth, eh? I don't remember the exact quote, but it was something along the lines of... It's like, oh, I'll have to go down and visit there. It's like, I'm gonna go up the, what was it? It's like, I'm gonna go down there and visit, maybe pick up some space eggs and blow it the fuck up! Oh, sorry, lost my cool there. I'm just a little bit absolutely livid. Friggin' love that line. I don't know. I'm not a gigantic fan of making, references like that. Like, I'm a general. Fuck me. Oh. I'm alive. Fuck. Fuck yeah. I'm not dead. That's a miracle. Anyway, I'm a part of a generation that has basically grown up on online media, so I know it shouldn't be too incredibly tacky to quote people from online media. I'm not sure, like, when you're a part of it, it just feels awkward. I mean, I'm not a gigantic portion of it, that's for sure. But still, like, I'm on the internet, and I'm making references about the internet. It just feels dirty somehow. Oh god. Eyeball sparrows! Ah, god damn it. Ah, and now these things? Ah, fuck off! Oh, Jesus. No! God! Okay. Well, if I get hit once, I'm dead, so... I'm not gonna count my blessings yet. There we go. Okay, I gotta remember, it's... along this side, I think. This side, I think I'm safe. Oh, Jesus! Okay. See a guy I can bomb. There. Okay, are we done with the fucking gears? Ah! Okay, good. Oh, shit! I hate everything. Boy, I don't think, I don't know, I'm starting to wonder whether or not we're actually going to defeat a planet this episode. Because this is starting to get frustrating as hell. I think this is one of the reasons why a lot of these games I did not go back to them. Because God help me, I wasn't going to do these challenges again. Like, for as much as I like these games, oh god. Just no, not again, never again. Oh, shit. There you go. That's a good thing to poll you guys. What do you think is the hardest game you've ever played? Like, oh, like... give me a good bar for it. Now, I know I played Contra, and I actually beat Contra, but I didn't beat pure Contra, which basically means without the Konami code. No, I was a dirty code user. Sorry. I beat it, though. I mean, I guess. But that's definitely not the hardest thing you could possibly do. Dark Souls is up there. Yeah, I would say that. Yeah. I haven't played Dark Souls. Actually, I haven't played any, like, the Souls kind of games. Or Bloodborne. Stuff like that. I know I probably should. Just because... I mean, like, they've got amazing praise, and... it's just, like, it's a game that has actual challenge. My god. What kind of world are we living in? Actual, you know, actual honest-to-god challenge? That doesn't belittle a player's playing abilities? Wow. Then again, I suck. I do all the belittling for them. Okay. I think I left that one. Yep. Okay, now I just need to not die. There we go. Okay. Almost there. Here we go! I didn't even get close to the points I needed. Jesus. What could I have picked up there? God. Alright. So, is this the last... Yeah, this is the last one. I think after this, I'm pretty much done for tonight. I think Baruta is really difficult. And we can save another planet for another time. So, let's do this shit. I have no fucking idea. Okay, what bird voice should I... I'm Baruta, Big Brother Endall's first pupil! Oh god, that's not a bird voice. I held Million hostage, so... Oh god. You have giantism. Oh. You mean this is a trap? Apparently. We'll settle this over there. Get ready, Bomberman. Oh, that hurts the eyes. Just the flashes of red and blue, Jesus. Okay. So, I can't save the princess, can I? Here I come, I guess. Oh, yeah. Okay, what do I do? I'm scared. I am very scared. I got plenty of stuff. Let's just try to drop bombs on this guy, see what happens. I missed all of them. Cool. Okay, I got him once. Cool. I need to avoid those. I mean, I'd imagine. I'm fairly certain the pink blobs are not cotton candy. I don't... There we go. Okay. I'm doing decent enough. Carpet bombing the fuck out of him. There you go. Oh, and now he shoots, oh wait, wasn't he shooting them before? Out of his ass? When does he shoot the laser beam? I'm terrified, I'm scared. Oh, here we go. Where the hell did that go? Oh, fuck! Okay, missed all of those. Yeah. Okay, got him. Dick laser! Yes. Exactly. I wish that's it. I want that to be his battle cry. Just like, I hope you enjoy my dick laser! Wow. I'm kind of cleaning house with this guy. I mean, unless there's some... really awful final form that splits him into like three. I think I've got this in the bag. He hasn't hit me once. Anybody dizzy yet? Got him. Oh my god, that's it. Really? Wow. Okay. I really did terrible on points, but whatever. Dick laser and shit blaster. Yep. That'll do. Deactivated lasers with my dick. The princess is on Canatia? Canatia Star? Alright. I swear, they just threw a whole bunch of these names from... Like, they went to some... sci-fi name generator online, picked out the ones that they thought sounded the coolest, and it's like, yep, that'll do. Prepare for a shitty rating. I got blue. Whatever. Oh, bonus stage. Okay. Do I die from touching those? I'd like to think I don't. I don't. Sweet. I'm cool with this. Oh, it's a bouncy pad. All right. Okay. I wonder how this, like, these levels factor into the overall score that you get. Because, like, I don't think you can ever get back to them. Unless... unless you defeat the boss, maybe. Like, a second time. Yoink. This is... trippy as hell. Let me go. One more row of it. Four. And five. Perfect, apparently? Alright. I'll take your word for it. Alright. So that's one more planet down. Next one we're going to is... Canatea, I guess. Well, here's a quick preview of the next place that we're going to, Hades Crater. Definitely not going to go too much into this. It's so hot, my life meter is getting low. No, that's just your battery. I neglect the fuck out of you. Sort of like how I just charge my cell phone whenever it's yelling at me. When your life meter gets low, enter the cooling cap. Oh my god. I just remembered these levels. Okay. Yeah. Fall into lava. You're a smart cookie. Oh my god. Okay. Alright. So... my life meter's gonna go down at some point? Apparently? Just as time goes on, is the life meter just gonna, like, lower and lower? Probably. I can't tell. Do I need to reach bottom before that happens? I have no idea. Alright, well, anyway, that'll do it. I'm not gonna go into this planet. We can just jump into the next planet the next time we play. Yes, sir. Alright. Oh, well, that ought to do it. Let me think. I'm trying to remember if there's anything else I need to talk about before I exit this place. Oh, just another reminder for anybody who's in the chat. If you have any recommendations for some music that you would like to hear at the beginning of my streams, like, you know, I usually start the stream and run it for about 10 minutes before the show actually begins. So if you've got any particular music tracks that you want to listen to during that segment, by the way, video game music specifically, let me know. Because, there's a lot of video game music that I personally like, but I know that a lot of you probably have your own personal favorites, and hey, you never know, maybe something will actually link up, and I don't know, just your favorite might actually be one of mine, and I'm just not thinking about it. I know I'm getting a little bit sick of Metallica, fuck that. I mean, Metallica's an awesome band, but let me tell you, not video game. Not really. Although, who was that one band that covered the Duke Nukem? The Duke Nukem theme? There's an official band that did that at one point. I don't remember. Anyway. So that's that. I'm gonna get a move on pretty soon here. But anyway, but aside from that, thanks everybody for coming out and watching. If you want to catch this stream anytime after it's done, you can check it out on my YouTube channel. I will upload it as soon as I possibly can after this level, after this show is done. I stream on Saturdays, Sundays, and Wednesdays, all of them at 7 o'clock. On Saturdays and Sundays, I play more recent games. Like, for instance, I've dived into... Stardew Valley recently, and oh god, I want to get back to it. I haven't touched it since we played it last Sunday. And Jesus, I want to. Oh wait, we didn't play it Sunday, we played it Saturday, right? Whatever. I played, literally, it was only like 4 or 5 days ago, and Jesus, I have been itching to try it out again. And then, again, on Wednesday, I play some more retro games and stuff that I played in my past, or just stuff that I consider older than the hills. All right, that should do it for everything. See you later, everybody.